Hello. Today I'd like to test something that was mentioned by Steve. So thank you again, Steve, for pointing me into this direction. And it sounds like an interesting idea to start in File Browser on the C64 Mini and see whether the file browser is able to leave the disk image and to access other files on the C64 Mini or well, to be correct, on the USB thumb drive. So, and in order to do so, I have already prepared a USB stick. And the next thing I'd like to test is whether Kira is useful in order to use a keyboard on the C64 Mini. Well, even if this is not going to be the main usage, because I mean, if you see that this keyboard is much bigger than the C64 Mini itself, it is an interesting, let's say, exercise. And you may ask, what's Kira? Well, Kira is one of those cool devices that has been created, but it is not longer available. So this was built by individual computers. And it is this small device here. And this can be used to connect a C64 keyboard or a C16 keyboard or a an Amiga keyboard and even joysticks via USB to a PC or whatever USB compliant device. And I can show you briefly how this is going to look like if we're going to switch to my laptop for a brief moment. And here I have a text editor. And if I'm going to step into this Windows, I can use the C64 keyboard to write in my Windows text editor. So there are a couple of alignment issues or well, assignment issues. So I haven't spent that much time looking for a good keyboard layout which represents the C64 keyboard in a way that most of the keys at least are okay. But the interesting thing is that if I'm going to switch it to German, for example, I have to so-call it Umlaute as well. And well, basically, most of the keys are working pretty fine, and you can use the C64 keyboard to write stuff on your Windows PC. And that's probably one of my next projects, to kind of create a keyboard with a small case, so pretty compact thing, and using Kira to connect this to my Windows PC. But anyway, that's not going to be the issue or the topic of today. We want to see whether Kira is recognized by the C64 Mini and if we can use the keyboard this way. So, in order to do so, we go switch back to the C64 Mini and I'm going to disconnect Kira from my laptop right now. And here this the C64 mini screen, and just to avoid that we get kind of bored by the same music over and over again, I just set it to mute. And this is going to be the USB cable. I had to get this out of this mess on my desk. So let's connect this to the C64 mini. And I learned that the C64 Mini isn't really recognizing USB devices all the time if you just plug them in. So let's have a quick reboot and then let's go to basic and see whether we have some keys. This would be really an awesome thing, but I guess it's going to be a little bit tricky to control the C64 Mini just with the keyboard, So the next thing we have to add is a USB hub, and then we are able to connect more USB devices. It's really funny to see that we need a USB hub to work with a C64. So, and as we can see, I can type, and that's indeed a pretty cool thing. And I'm really surprised. I haven't expected this. And this is amazing. So I'm blown away. I haven't expected this. So and even the layout seems to be okay. Let's press a couple of keys. No, that's wrong. Okay. So it's not as perfect as it seems at the very beginning. But I think this is indeed something we can work with, but now we have the issue with the USB devices, that we have too much of them. But somewhere on my chaos here, I have a USB hub. So let's see whether we can get this to work. And just to keep things simple, I'm going to disconnect the... Oh, it jumped out of basic. I'm going to disconnect the joystick, and then we set the joystick to the USB hub on this port, and we're going to use the USB thumb drive on this port, and then let's head back to basic. May have to arrange this a little bit differently, but anyway. So let's see whether we can load a directory. Here we go, that's fine. Okay, so what I've done is I copied two programs on this disk image, and one that's going to be the file browser, and I took this NEF96. Because this one is able to be controlled by joystick. So this could be an interesting thing, because the keyboard function is probably not really what we are looking for. Ah, okay, now we need... okay, everything is fine. Let's load this one. And it looks like the next thing I have to test is a fast loader. So I haven't expected to spend that much time with the C64 Mini and on the basic screen, or on the basic option. It was well meant to be a game console. But actually I have so many things to do, I have no time for gaming at all. And I'm actually not sure whether this is doing something. It appears to be a little bit slow. Oh, okay. So let's start this one. Loading directory. Okay, so now we may have to switch to full screen. And then let's see whether we can use the joystick. Yes, we can. That's cool. A little bit hard. Home. Okay. That's home. So I have to admit, I have no idea how I have to control this one. So this is just for up and down, looks like. No, it's doing actually nothing. So, oh, loading changes. Ah, okay. That wasn't my intention right now. So we may have to check how we have to operate this program. So give me a brief second. Oh. let's see whether we can find some kind of shortcut list or something like this. What's new? Okay. That wasn't really something I was looking for, but maybe we find some information. No. About the usage of the program. So let's step out of it. Buy ready. Oh, now we have a custom font. That's interesting. Cool. So let's see whether we still have. Oh, that's probably not going to work, but let's give it a test. Oh, well, it's working. So let's jump back to NAV 1696.8. Load it again, and in the meantime I'm going to check whether I can find some interesting information. You can now choose from 12 different backgrounds. Okay, well, that's not really what I was looking for. Okay, and NAV 96 means that's the version 0.9.6. Okay, so that's not really the name of the program itself, but it's still not really talking about how to operate this. Okay, so it won't start again, so we may have to reset. Or basic and jump back. So so it looks like this one isn't really helpful, because what we need is an what we need is a file browser that's specifically made for SD2IC devices. So we may go for file browser. That's something I was using. Long name, whatever. SD browser. Okay, SD browser sounds promising. So let's copy it to my USB drive and see whether this is helpful. SD browser. Okay, so now we have to look into this. It looks a little bit strange. Not really what I was expecting. Mm. A lot of discussion at CSDB about this program. And well, I downloaded it and the zip contains some weird files, so I'm not sure whether I just have to copy them onto my disk drive or my disk image. But well, let's give it a try. Sick, sick. It's a little bit strange. SDB. I think it's supposed to be a PRG. And maybe this one as well, PRG, and then we just copy it to our disk drive and get rid of the other stuff. And let's see whether this one is working. So, no, this way. Perhaps we have no drive at all. Let's have a check. Oh, it's doing something. Okay, but it hasn't recognized that I have changed something. So that's a little bit pity that there is no reset function. So we may have to jump out of it and start again. Or in worst case, we have to reboot C64 Mini. Oops, wrong. Oh, now we got nothing at all. That's interesting. So then let's try reboot. So maybe that's something that could work. Shutting down. It's a little bit strange that a short press is shutting down and a long press is switch on. My opinion, the opposite would be more appealing, but anyway. So then let's go for this one. So cursor keys aren't working. Ah, that's a pity. Anyway. Okay, so let's hope that this one is loading now. It's just a guess that I had to rename it. And well, yeah, the next thing I have to look for is a fast loader. If I'm going to continue working on the basic screen of the C64 Mini. So. But well, maybe the next update will bring more functions or options to handle disk images, and then I think the real fun starts having more games on the C64 Mini. Oh, it's doing something, okay. SD browse, okay. So. F1 for help. Let's see. Oh, he okay. Dum-dum-dum-dum. Parent directory. Select device. Duplicate panels. Device info. Transfer between disk and D64 image. F7. Device, Android Infrastructure, AB Select Device. Okay, let's see whether we can go to root, run stop to exit. Okay, so what happened with F2? Oh, we're still in the same disk image. So A, what's doing A? Nothing. B is doing nothing. Then what else do we have? Device information, refresh directory, parent directory. What happens here? Nothing. So it looks like we can't get out of this disk image. Shift parent. Transfer, use cursor keys, home to move, run stop to exit. Well, cursor keys works fine. Home works fine. And then let's press E. Doing nothing. Device information. I refresh directory. So the keys aren't doing anything at all. That's a little bit weird. But we have some backup keyboard. Maybe it's just an issue of oh, my shortcuts stopped working. Let's see what happens when we press E here. Nothing. Okay. So, well, on the one side we have a file browser, but actually it's not really adding that much functionality. Except that loading programs is a little bit more comfortable. Especially if you have longer names or names that can be typed in quite easily. And this is mostly the case when we copy things from a non-C64 system to a USB drive or something like this and use those file names on the C64, can't interpret those strange whatever file names. Especially if they are too long or if they contain strange characters which are not available on the normal C64 keyboard, like a underline or something like this. And so what I've loaded now is the C64 Doctor Diagnostic Sequence. Usually I'm using this program on a cartridge. But since there's no cartridge connector, actually, we can use this one to check certain functions of the C64 Mini. And let's check. Press return to test the keyboard or press space to select the next device. Okay, press space. Cassette is not working. Disk drive. So let's see what happens when we test the disk drive. How to use this test requires that a disk drive be switched on and connected to C64 and that a scratch diskette be inserted into the drive. Press B to begin test or E to exit. So well, I think it's going to delete my disk, which is something I'm not really looking for right now. There's no printer. Here we can test the monitor. Well, let's do so. Press B to begin test. Oh, we got some colors. Well, okay. Some people complain about the color representation of the C64 Mini, and perhaps it's a little bit too, well, colorful. So, but it is a little bit tricky because on the one side, if we talk about a 65-69 WIC chip, it has a different color representation compared to the 85-65. and therefore there is no one real C64 color. And I think it depends a lot on the monitor as well. But I've seen a lot lengthy discussions, especially on emulator threads, about color representation. But well, that's actually not my main issue, main topic. So to me, it looks a little bit too colorful. That could be maybe a complaint, but that's not really very problematic, so to say. So then press space. Audio. Okay, for this we have to enable audio so that we can hear something, and I hope everything is working fine. Let's see whether we can hear something. Fine tuning TV set, volume on TV monitor, cable TV, mute switches, etc. B to begin. Okay, we can hear something. Okay, it's testing the three voices with a very special test tune. That's probably not very challenging for the SID, so even an emulated SID should be able to do this without any problems. Press B to begin test. Now I think we are not going to test this again. So joysticks. Well, okay, let's test the joystick. How to use? Blah 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 blah. Press B to begin. Okay. Press spacebar to select between joystick 1 and joystick 2. So, well, anyway, I have no idea. I think joystick 2. And now let's see whether we can test the joystick. Well, it's doing something, so it's not very surprising. Okay, press B to test other joystick. Okay, it's doing nothing. That was kind of expectable. So let's jump out, and as last thing, let's check the RAM. Press B to begin. Press spacebar to select between single and continuous testing. Well, I think a single test should be fine. So, see a couple of blue dots. I'm just expecting Pac-Man to come and eat them all. RAM test successfully completed. Press E to exit. So, well, this program was, well, on the one side showing that most of the stuff is working. And I haven't expected anything else. And just for fun, we can check the keyboard. Because now we got one. But this test is not really showing some internals or something like this. And here we see that not all of the keys are transferred correctly. But most of them, it looks like. By whatever reason this was, this is like K7, and this is the ad, and this is, okay, so there's some kind of a mix-up of some of the keys here. So at least this program is helpful to understand how Kira is transferring keys to the C64 Mini. And although there's probably no chance to change something, because it is as it is, and we are not able to load different keyboard layouts on the C64 Mini, but at least a small cheat sheet could help to understand which key needs to be pressed to get a certain character or something like this. I mean, the characters and the numbers and all that stuff is working fine, but especially those special keys here, they appear to be a little bit mixed up. And well, anyway, that's actually quite interesting. So okay, and basically that's all what I want to do today. And I'm really happy that the keyboard is working, and perhaps it's not going to be my main usage or my main installation, but for further, let's say, basic tests or disk image, whatever tests, it's a little bit more comfortable to have the keyboard to type in load and all that stuff instead of using the virtual keyboard. But well, let's see what the next update is going to offer us for the C64 Mini, and how this whole story is going to continue. So as usual, thank you very much for watching, and if you have any ideas, like Steve coming up with new suggestions what I have to test, then feel free to use the comment section. I'm highly appreciated. And if you want to stay informed about the next videos, the next updates, whatever I'm going to do, then feel free to use the subscribe function as well. So thanks for watching, and bye bye.